Hi there, my name is Annie Lalla. I'm a love and relationship coach, and welcome to this video. This video today is for the singles out there, people who are ready to find their life partner, their soulmate. They would really like to find that one person to create a future with. And the frame I want to give you is that as you're dating, every date you go on is actually an interview, okay? You are literally interviewing to hire someone for the most important role in your entire life, okay? No human will influence how you develop or not, how you grow and change more than the partner, the romantic partner that you choose. It is the most important decision you're gonna make in your life. So you wanna treat it that way. And when you're gonna hire someone for the most important job, you are going to have a particular scrupulousness, okay? I want you to see yourself as the interviewer, not the interviewee, okay? You are choosing the highest quality person to create a future, build a life, perhaps build a family, to be the parent of your future children. Okay, this is no small decision. Each person that you're dating, okay, I want you to approach them in a certain way. And I want you to approach them as if how you behave with them is going to get reported to your future partner. Okay, it's almost like every date, the information of how you're behaving on that date is going to be collected and given to your future romantic partner that you choose. And they're gonna see all the information. If that was actually true, the way you would act on each date would be much more intentional, conscious, deliberate, and according to your actual values, okay? No one would be disposable. And I'm using this as a kind of thought experiment. But I'm also suggesting something that I tell my clients often as a kind of metaphor too, that say you're a man and you go on dates with women, every woman that you go on a date with is an avatar of the divine feminine and is a representative of your future goddess, of your future queen. And these women that you're dating, that you're interacting with, are practice representations of your future goddess. And how you act with them shapes your own esteem and shapes the PR that other people have of how you are in relationship. And the suggestion I'm gonna make is to treat every interaction with another woman, especially a romantic one, as if it's practice for the one, okay? You don't just save your best game for the one. You want to bring it to your practice. Imagine if you were an Olympic athlete, okay, and you're practicing for the Olympics. Every time you do rehearsal, every time you go and work out and you do your disciplined practice weekly, daily, you don't bring your half-assed game, you bring your full game. You keep practicing bringing your full game of your most triumphant, beautiful, sensitive, consistent with your values self. You want to bring your A game every time you meet a woman, every time you interact with a woman on a date. As if how you're behaving is going to leak forward to your future wife's ears, okay? Each woman you're dating is an avatar for the divine feminine, and they are practice for you treating a woman like she is a miracle happening once and for all and never again. And the more opportunities you get to practice, the better you'll be when you actually find your soulmate. So it's a different approach. Instead of like, oh, I'm gonna date 5 minutes into the date, I realize I don't think I'm gonna marry this girl. You don't start behaving in a way that's inconsistent with your magnificence and your beauty and your intelligence. You wanna treat her in a way, she is someone's daughter. She's might be someone's future soulmate. She's someone's sister. She's a human being and she's a miracle. And if you can find a way to speak to her for the rest of the time of the date and make sure she leaves the date feeling better for having had the interaction with you. You want to leave people better than you found them. And if you take on this, whoever you're dating is either the one or practice for the one. If you bring that approach to every interaction with a woman, or if you're dating men, with a man, you will find the best version of yourself coming forward. You will be practicing being amazing. You'll be practicing loving other people. You'll be practicing doing relationship with the kind of grace and finesse and intelligence that your future soulmate will actually demand and require. So you might as well practice now, right? Bring your A game to every interaction, because how good you are in your practice determines how good you are in the final situation, when it's game time, when it's the Olympics, okay? So I want you to take this on if you're single. I want you to take this well on if you're a man, if you're a woman, and you're going on dates and you're interacting with people of the opposite sex or the same sex, whoever you're attracted to. Each person you interact with is either the one or practice for the one. So always bring your A game, okay? It'll cultivate in you a sense of beauty and pride and the kind of self-esteem that will attract the highest caliber mate possible. And when Mr. or Mrs. Right comes into your life, they will recognize you and they will get all the whisperings from all the people you went on dates with energetically. And they will be able to decide whether this is the mate for them or not. Okay? She's either the one or practice for the one. He's either the one or practice for the one. So bring your A game. All right, I hope you liked this video and learned something. Leave comments below or any questions that you have. And I'll see you next time.